So before we go in, we gotta get some hand sanitizer, clean our hands. Really important to clean our feet too, because they don't want to bring in any external parasites or anything like that. So this hydroponic garden clearly makes a really great use of space as far as packing density and what you can grow in this small space. How many different varieties of lettuce are you growing here?
Currently we have 13 different types of lettuce that we grow, and that's all harvested twice a week and then packed here, put in a walk-in cooler, and then put in our delivery truck that we drive around Nashville twice a week.
Awesome, yeah. I'm here with Jeffrey Orkin. He's with Greener Roots Farm. This is one of his newest projects, I think his second location.
Correct.
We're here at South Hall Farms. Yeah, this is a beautiful greenhouse that we're in. And so you kind of corrected me a little earlier and said this is kind of hydroponic. So explain to me about your process.
Yeah, so both of our locations, we exclusively grow hydroponically. So that means that there's no soil involved at any step of the process. So in this specific type of hydroponics is called raft hydroponics. So what that means is these are styrofoam rafts that are floating on the water. And so you can see there's no soil anywhere. The roots are coming out of the bottom and they're floating in a nutrient solution, and the plants take up the nutrients that they need, and what they don't need is just recirculated in the system. So for that reason, hydroponics is often touted as a really efficient use of water.
Right.
We actually use about 90% less water than conventional agriculture because of the fact that it's being recirculated.
Right.
The plants use what they need. There's very little evaporation in this system, so mostly transpiration occurs.
Right, yeah, there's not a lot of exposed water to the
sunlight. Yeah, exactly.
Which helps a lot with that.
There's 10 rows of rafts here, and this entire mix goes into our most popular Nashville blend, which has all 10 of these lettuces. That's like a, just
wow.
To your point, it's a really pretty mix of lettuces.
Yeah, very colorful.
Yeah.
So how long has this been growing in this solution? Like, what's your time frame?
Yeah, so from seed to harvest on most of these varieties is about 40 to 50 days. However, the first 2 weeks of its life is not in this big finishing pond.
Okay.
So we start the lettuce in these 10 by 20 trays in our vertical farm, and then they're grown there for 2 weeks, and then they come here and we're transplanted into the higher density spacing that you see at the other end of the pond.
Yeah.
And then this is our finished spacing. So we've got 18 heads in a 2x4 raft.
Wow. Talk about square foot gardening.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and we're pulling almost 2,000 heads a week and just over 800 pounds a week. So between the two facilities, last year we did 14 tons of produce from the previous facility. And with this facility and the other facility, we'll probably do over 30 tons of lettuce in a year.
Wow.
So it's a very efficient process.
Yes.
Yeah.
I do have to ask, having grown lettuce myself at home in the ground.
Yeah.
How do you keep these from bolting?
So a lot of that is just climate control.
Okay.
Controlling the water temperature.
Okay.
We have artificial lighting in here. We have a sensor that you can see that's hanging out just at the plant canopy.
Uh-huh.
So the whole greenhouse is controlled by a fancy computer system.
Gotcha.
And we say, hey, we want this much light every day. And if we're not getting enough light, the lights come on.
Right.
And that's a great way, if it's hotter temperatures, we can dial back the amount of light that we want the crop to get, and that'll slow down the growth rate and decrease the chance of bolting.
So that's what's the causes of bolting, I guess?
I mean, normally it's stress. So it's the plant trying to produce seed so that it can survive as a species.
Okay.
And so if you can reduce stress factors, oftentimes for lettuce in the soil, that has to do with heat.
Right.
It could have to do with nutrient deficiencies and other things. So again, this is controlled environment agriculture, oftentimes called CEA. And that's the whole shtick with CEA, is that you're manipulating all the factors in order to produce the best product year round.
Right. It shows.
Yeah. It's 100 degrees outside right now, and we've got beautiful lettuce growing. So.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
So this is how they start.
Yeah. Correct. So we start the seeds in something called rock wool, which is it's like cotton candy of rock, spun rock that's heated up and then shaped into this shape.
Methodical process.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it is.
Very uniform process as well.
So you have a really advanced computer system that controls the lighting and the temperature. Is that the same for the water in the ponds?
That system doesn't control that, but we do have this Blue Lab system that monitors water temperature, pH, and the nutrient salt levels. It's called electrical conductivity.
Okay.
And so it's literally just measuring a salt level. And we know ranges that are appropriate. And then in addition to that, we do monthly water tests. And so we'll send them to a lab, and that will give us a full panel of all the micro and macronutrients.
Wow.
That's another one of the really cool aspects of hydroponic farming, is we're able to do that on a regular basis. And that means that literally every month we can say, hey, we need more calcium, or we need more potassium, or more nitrogen. And we have the ability to adjust for specific nutrients instead of just some kind of a blanket treatment.
Right, right. Yeah. What is the main source of fertilizer for these that you put in the water?
We use a more conventional bagged fertilizer. They're all designed for hydroponics. However, you know, a very common, if we need magnesium, we use magnesium sulfate,
sure,
also known as Epsom salt.
Sure,
so,
yeah.
It's not like we're pouring crazy stuff in here.
Right.
But they're designed for hydroponics, and they come in a powder form in a bag, and then we mix them with water.
Yeah.
So we have a kind of a custom solution that we've perfected over the past 5 years of being in business.
Cool. Yeah. One of my favorite questions to ask gardeners is, I see the yellow pads out there, obviously, to catch flies and whatnot.
Yeah.
What are some major issues that you've run into that you found good solutions for?
Yeah, we use sticky traps primarily for insect identification.
Okay.
However, thrips are one of the largest issues in a lettuce farm.
Right.
And they love yellow sticky traps. We don't spray any pesticides or herbicides, and so we have to do other control methods, and that's one of our go-tos. We do also introduce beneficial insects, and
cool.
So there are, for example, if we do see aphid populations that are outside of our comfort zone, or thrip populations that are outside of our comfort zone, we can introduce either a parasitic wasp or a mite that will then go after the problem insect.
Oh, wow.
And it's quite fascinating. They're so small that you can't see them at all, but you'll just notice the insect populations dropping down. So
that's very cool.
Yeah, very cool.
Yeah, so still staying in the natural processes.
Exactly.
But in a controlled environment at the same time.
For
so it's
sure.
really understanding how nature works to be able to control it. So we're here at these fish ponds. Is that what you call them?
It's an aquaculture system.
Okay, aquaculture system. And what do you use this for?
So we are growing hybrid striped bass for the purpose of selling the fish for consumption.
Oh, wow, okay.
So this system is not being used to create fertilizer. This is not an aquaponics greenhouse. It's a hydroponic greenhouse that also raises fish. We've spent nearly 6 years perfecting hydroponics, and this is our first time growing fish, and so we didn't want to complicate trying to connect those two things. This is two different living systems, and connecting them together is a little bit difficult. So,
do we get to feed them?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. They're hungry.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's really cool. So you get these in, I guess, as like little
yeah,
tiny fish?
They come in as fingerlings. When we got them in January, they were like a 10 to 12 gram fish. And we've actually been working through getting the system working correctly, but they're already up to about 55 or 60 grams.
Wow.
And we're gonna harvest them to almost a 2 pound fish.
What are some of the other fun things that you would say about hydroponic gardening?
It's a really rewarding way to see things grow quickly, especially if you have your nutrient recipe dialed in. I know for a lot of people that wanna get into gardening, and you're in the backyard and things aren't working out well because you don't have enough sun, or you didn't actually pay attention to your soil quality.
Right.
This is a much easier way to like have a successful first go around. Now, granted, there's plenty of errors that can happen along the way, but it is nice coming in on a 100 degree day and seeing several thousand heads of ready to eat lettuce that are just perfect in the summer.
Yeah.
I didn't go to school for this. I'm a landscape architect, as you know, so a lot of my knowledge was just gained from watching YouTube videos, trying things, experimenting. I know right. The very first volunteer gardener in 2013 was in my little experimental lab, so.
Yeah, it was in a closet space that you had packed full of stuff.
At the top of a building in downtown is where we started in 2013, so it's come a long way.
Yeah, so lots of trial and error.
Exactly, yes, to absolutely, get here. Yeah.
Thank you for doing this and showing us your farm. It's beautiful.
Thanks.
It's comfortable, and it looks enjoyable.
Come back anytime.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah.
For inspiring garden tours, growing tips, and garden projects, visit our website at volunteergardener.org or on YouTube at the Volunteer Gardener channel and like us on Facebook.